My name is Li Ming Liu, and you could call me Ethan. I'm now studying some technical grading and software in order to prepare to join a design team, which is determined to build up a new carbon city in Shenzhen. So, why do I decide to be an architect? I was determined to be an architect when I was a little. So, while growing up, I found there was a lot of problems in the environment we live in, like the pollution, food shortage, energy shortage, and climate change. And that's why I decided to be an architect and in order to build a better living environment. So to me, just as Louis Kahn said, that architect is not a business, it's my religion, my faith, it's my dedicated to the cause of humans' enjoyment and happiness. And out of the study and works, I'd like to play guitar and doing some extreme sports. And that's it. Thank you. Pollution, energy shortage, food shortage, and climate change, so these are all the significant problems we are facing today. So I think that all the problems we are experiencing today are created by us. And for everything created by us, we should have a solution. That all of these problems we are facing in today's urban living, there is a solution. But that is very difficult for us to solve these problems in current city planning. That's the unfinished Tokyo Millennium Tower inspired me. The Tokyo Millennium Tower is proposed by the Norman Foster, which could accommodate 60,000 of people inside of the building. I bring up an idea. What about that put dozens of building sites like the Millennium Tower together? But in my planning, all of them are designed independently but connected with the huge hubs in the air. In a system which have around 30 or 40 buildings like the Millennium Towers inside, it is very easy for it to accommodate more than 1.5 million people in this system. And with the cordless elevator's help, it is very easy for the residents to reach the destination within 30 minutes. That means that there is no more vehicles needed. And there will also be some high-speed railway under the vertical city, help the residents to travel from one vertical city to another one. I also plan to build some school, library, or some museum, this kind of infrastructure in these buildings. And it will help the residential to have a similar experience in the horizontal city. And we have these huge hubs in the air, which work like a street to provide that residents of the experience in the horizontal city. And in just in a community like this, it is able to create the energy itself, like use the solar energy or use the stable winds in the high altitude to use the wind energy. And it will also depose the waste itself. And this will create a vertical city and maintain, we will create a new city system and maintain the meet the various needed. And that's it. Thank you.